or is minus sign is already there, will be positive then. It is minus sign, but in this case it will be positive, but minus sign is already there. It will be positive then. Okay, so it will be positive. From this onwards it will be positive. This is positive here. Last one is positive. This one is positive. So integration is this answer. The answer is this in three terms. Okay, finally we have obtained the answer of this question. Question number fourth we have done. Let's talk about fifth question. So question number fifth, let's talk about it. Okay, so make it clear to the problem. Question number 5 now. Now let's talk about question number 5. Okay, that is there. So what did you say? Now question number 5. Okay. Question number 5 now. It is sign of integration x upon x minus 1 whole square into x plus 2 into dx. Now it's a proper fraction, so let x upon x minus 1 whole square into x plus 2 equal to a upon x plus 2 plus b upon x minus 1 plus c upon x minus 1 whole square. Okay, x minus 1 whole square. This is the fifth question. No problem. Oh, okay. So, cross multiply, x equal to, taking this to that side, will be a into x minus 1 whole square plus b into x minus 1 into x plus 2 plus c into only x plus 2. Or it can be further written as a into x square minus twice x plus 1 plus b into, it can be x square plus x minus 2. If I multiply these two, then twice x minus x and plus x. 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. And x into x is x square. Plus c into x plus 2 only. Now substituting the value. Okay, for value of a, for value of c, we have to find out for value of a. Substituting. Or substitute or substituting. This is for me substituting x plus 2 equal to 0 or x equal to minus 2 in first. We get, here we get x equal to minus 2, this is minus 2 equal to a into minus 2 square. Only a will be calculated, minus 2 whole square. Minus 2 into minus 2 is 1. Only this value is calculated. Okay, only this value will be calculated. Others are 0, because minus 2 if I substitute, in this case, minus 2, minus 2, minus 4, this is plus 4, minus 2 square means plus 4, plus 4, minus 4, 0, this is minus 2, plus 2, 0, only a is calculated. What is that? Let me write here, a into plus 4, and this is minus 4, plus 1, only 1 is left, sorry, this is plus 4, I'm sorry, minus 2 into minus 2 means plus 4, this is 9, equal to 9 into 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9. 9 a equal to minus 2 or a equal to, let me write again, minus 2 upon 9. Minus 2 upon 9. This 9 is there, 9. Here we have taken. Okay, so a is calculated. This is value of a. Now for value of c, the last value, for value of c, putting x minus 1 whole square 0, or x minus 1 equal to 0, or x equal to 1 in first, we get, this is the first equation. In first equation we are substituting. In this one we substitute. Okay, so x equal to 1 here, 1 equal to, only c will be calculated. This is 1 plus 1, 3. c equal to 1.3. This is 0, why? Because 1 plus 1 minus 2, 0, 2 minus 2, 0. This is 1 plus 1, 2, minus 2, 0, 2 minus 2, 0. A 0, B 0, but C is there. C into 3. Or C equal to, rather C equal to 1.3. C is 1.3 equal to 0. Now for A, we have to include the coefficients of x squared. For value of A, sorry, B in this case, for value of that for value of v equating coefficients of x square. Here it is 0 because new x square in the left hand side. Here it is a plus b, but a is known minus 2.9, so b is plus 2.9. We have minus 2.9 plus b equal to 0. Implies that b is equal to plus 2.9. B is equal to 2.9 is positive. 2.9 here. Okay, so this is all the three values are calculated of constants. Let me therefore express the given fraction in the form of partial fractions in this way. What is that way? Therefore, x upon x minus 1 whole square into x plus 2 is equal to a. A is minus 2 upon 9 into x plus 2 in bracket. Okay, this is plus 2 upon 9 b. That would be, this is into x minus 1. That would be, okay. Plus c is 1.3. That means into x minus 1 whole square. 1.3 into x minus 1 whole square. Therefore, integration of x upon x plus 2 into x minus 1 whole square into dx is equal to minus 2 upon 9 integration sign dx upon x plus 2 plus 2 upon 9 integration sign dx upon x minus 1 plus 1.3. And for dx, we want point x minus 1 into dx. Now, finally, they can integrate. Integration of this will be minus 2 upon 9 log of x plus 2 plus 2 upon 9. Sorry, integration of this will be log of x minus 1. Now, again, this will be minus sign. Is minus 1.3, 1 upon x minus 1 only. Because this will be taken the numerator, x minus 1 whole power minus 2, integration will be x minus 1 whole power minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1, negative value in the denominator, it will be positive minus minus, sorry, it will be positive, it will be negative, and this will be x minus 1 whole power minus 1, that minus 2 can be taken the numerator. This is the higher order constant of integration. Let me write c here, okay, let me write a constant, so that it can be different from c. Okay, constant. So this is the answer here. Or these two can be combined together. If we put upon that common, it will be positive value first, it will be log of m minus log, and that means log x minus 1 upon x plus 2 minus 1 upon 3 into x minus 1. This value plus k constant. This is the answer here. Question number 5 done. This is question number 5 we have done. Now that we talk about. Next question. Question number 6 now. Let us talk about. Okay, so question number 6. What did you say? Now let's talk about question number 6. Question number 6 now. Okay, it is 1 upon sine of integration 1 upon x squared minus 1 whole square into dx. This can be expressed as 1 upon x minus x squared minus 1. Means a squared minus b squared can be written as x minus 1 into x plus 1 whole square of these two into dx. That means this is nothing but 1 upon sine of integration x minus 1 whole square into x plus 1. Whole square in dx. No problem. So let, or it can be expressed in terms of partial fractions. Let x minus 1 whole square into x plus 1 whole square equal to b upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 1 whole square plus c upon x plus 1 plus d upon x plus 1 whole square. Now in this case, the value of b and d can be calculated by cross multiply. Let me first cross multiply this. You make a into x minus 1 into x plus 1 whole square. B into x plus 1 whole square plus c into x minus 1 whole square into 1 x plus 1 plus d into x minus 1 whole square. Let me further express this. So a into x minus 1 into x square twice x plus 1 whole square of x plus 1. And this is b into x square twice x plus 1 whole square of x plus 1 and b plus c into x square minus twice x plus 1 whole square of x minus 1 and into x plus 1 into x plus 1. This d x minus 1 whole square is x square minus twice x plus 1. Okay. Now further, if I express this, this is a into x multiplying x cube plus twice x plus x minus x square minus twice x minus 1. This b is as it is x square plus twice x plus 1 plus c into, now if I multiply by x first, x cube minus twice x square plus x, now plus x square by 1. So minus twice x plus 1 plus d into the same value x square minus twice x plus 1. So that it can be easy now. So now coefficients, let me further summarize them. X cube is independent here. X cube twice x and first let me write minus x square. Okay, sorry. It will be x first we wrote it down. Is okay. Now then minus 1 is minus x square minus x square into plus minus 2x and minus 1. Okay, so x square only one time. But x into x square twice x square. Here it is. No, I'm sorry. This is twice x square here. But x into x square is x cube, x into twice x is x, twice x square. And then x plus x. Okay, now it is okay. Minus x square minus x twice x minus 1. Now it's okay. It will be plus x square only. Why? Because twice x square minus x square is plus x square. Positive x minus x is minus x and minus 1. Plus b into the same value x square plus twice x plus 1 plus c into. This value will be x cube minus twice x square plus x square minus x square plus x minus twice x minus x into plus 1 plus d into the same value x square minus twice x plus 1 and d. Now let me find out other values. Let me write it. Let me write this. Now this is 1 is equal to. So question number 1, this is question number 1 here. Let me write this number, question number 1, this whole value. Or if I write it here, that can also be done. Then calculation of value, let me write here, a into, same value here on the x square minus x plus minus 1, sorry. Plus b into x square minus twice plus twice x plus 1. This is plus c into x cube minus x square minus x plus 1. Plus d into x square minus twice x minus twice x plus 1. This value will be. This is equation number 1. Now let me wrap this. So this is question number 1. Now, from this equation, I have to find out all the values of constants. For b and d, we can find out values for b. For b, x minus 1 whole square equal to 0. of B for value of B. And so for value of B, for the value of B, putting x minus 1 whole square equal to 0 or x minus 1 equal to 0 or x equal to 1 in first. From this value of B will be calculated undoubtedly. And D can be highest power holding these denominators. The constant of those can be calculated only, not the these. A and C cannot be calculated by shortcut method in this case. Okay, so let me substitute x equal to 1 in this first equation. We will see that everything will be 0, only B will not be 0. This is 0 by 1 plus 1. If I substitute x equal to 1, this is 1 minus 1, minus 2 plus 0. This is also 0. This is 1, this is 1 plus 1, plus 2, sorry. This is 2 minus 2, 0. This is also 1 plus 1, 2 positive, and minus 2 positive, minus 2 negative, 0. Only A is calculated. So what is A here? 1 is equal to A into 1 plus 2, 1 minus 1. I'm sorry, this is something mistaken. If I x plus 1 into x minus 1 whole square. So A is 0, but B can be calculated on here. Yeah, this is 0. A is 0 because B we have to calculate. Why I'm writing this answer? So B will be only calculated. 1 plus 2 plus 1. 1 square plus 2 plus 1. A is 0. A is automatically 0. No problem. I think something else. Now B is calculated because B is having highest power of this one. For B we are calculated. B only calculated. That will not be 0, others will be 0. This is 4. 1 plus 2 plus 1. That is 4. So B is equal to 1.4. 4B. 1 is equal to, or B is equal to 1.4. So B is equal to 1.4. For B, now value of D can also be calculated by substituting. This is equation number 1. For value of B, putting x plus 1 whole square equal to 0, or x plus 1 equal to 0, whether x equal to minus 1 in first. So we will see that every constant A, B, C will be 0, other than only D will be calculated. So what is D here? So 1 equal to D into minus 1 in case of x, it will be minus 1 whole square, minus 2 into minus 1 is plus 2, plus 1, it is also 4. D into 1 plus 2 plus 1 is 4, so it is equal to 1. So D is equal to also 1.4. So D is also 1.4. Okay, so D and B are calculated. Now for A and C, let's frame the equations. Now you've got a coefficient of x cube first. X cube. Equating coefficients of x cube versus here. Equating coefficients. Coefficients of x cube, x here, etc. First x cube. It is 0 here in the left hand side, no x cube. This is A only, A into x cube, plus C into x cube, plus C. A plus C equal to 0, or A is given, sorry. Okay, A or C both are not given, I'm sorry. No problem. Let's take next equation, x square. Coefficient of x square will be what? So, x coefficient here, it is 0. Coefficient of x here, x square. Then A into x square, plus B into x square, plus B. Okay, minus C. Plus D. Okay, plus D. Now let me take X also, coefficient of X C. It will be 0 here again. It is minus A. It is no X. This is twice B. 2 into B into X. Okay, twice B. It is here. It is minus C. And D is minus 2D. Minus 2D. All the 4. Now, from these two equations only we can solve the other variation. How? But A, sorry, B and D are calculated. B and D can be substituted here. But this implies that 0 equal to A, nothing. B, B are not calculated. But C is, B is calculated. B is 1.4. B is calculated. This is 1.4. Minus C is not calculated, but D is calculated 1.4. Okay, and in this equation, it's inside it. In this equation also we can substitute 0 equal to minus A. Plus twice B means 2 upon 4. Minus C calculated minus 2 upon 4. D is also 1.4. Similar type of these two equations. But okay, this minus A is there. If I add these two, this is 1.4, this is also. Okay, if I add these two, add one addition. One addition we get. One addition. A and A cancel out, because minus A and plus A. This is 1.2, 2 upon 4, that means 3 upon 4. Here it is 0 on the left hand side. This is 1.4, 2 upon 4 means 3 upon 4. We solve it. Minus C means twice C, minus C, minus C. And these two are minus 1.4. Minus 2.4 and plus 1.4. Okay, so this is. Okay. Alright. So this is minus 1.4 and 3 upon 4, that means 2 upon 4. So, difference of 3 by 4 and 1.4 is 2 upon 4. 2 upon 4, let me write here. 2 upon 4 is equal to 0 and minus twice C equal to 0. Now this is equal to 0. Equal to 0. This implies that the 1.2. 1.2 here. So minus equal twice C equal to 1.2. C equal to 1.4. C is also 1.4. C is also 1.4. Very good. Now D, sorry, for A. We can substitute this value in this. A is minus 1.4. A is going to be minus 1.4 from first equation. But C is 1.4. From this equation we have obtained 2C equal to 1.2 or 1.4. C equal to 1.4. B is A is minus 1.4. Finally, all these values are calculated. Let me express this fraction in partial fractions in this way. What is that? Let me solve it then further. Okay, so this is A. A is 1.4. Logic minus 1.4. Minus 1.4 into x minus 1. Plus B is also 1.4. Into x minus 1 whole square. Plus C is 1.4. Everything is 1.4. Sorry. This is 1 upon epsilon integrated. It is x plus 1 here. This is plus 1.4 D. 2x plus 1 whole square. Okay, so finally, therefore, integration of 1 upon x squared minus 1 whole square into dx is equal to a upon e is minus 1.4 sine of integration dx upon x minus 1 plus 1.4 sine of integration 1 upon x minus 1 whole square plus 1.4 sine of integration 1 upon x 1 plus 1.4 sine of integration 1 upon x plus 1 whole square into dx into dx into dx. Okay, now it's integration. So we can integrate this is minus 1.4 log of x minus 1. Now it is again the same thing. X minus 1 whole square can take in the numerator, it will be x minus 1 whole minus 2. Then integration will be x minus 1 whole power minus 2 plus 1 or minus 2 plus 1. Negative value will be there. It is minus 1.4 1 form x minus 1 integration. This I have done number of times. This is plus 1.4 log of x plus 1 is only independent power 1 power. This is this value. Plus 1.4 or minus 1.4 will be again 20 minus 1.4 into s plus 1n. So the power minus 1 power will come in the denominator. That's constant of integration. Say that integral. Now here we can take some common here. Now this minus 1.4 minus 1.x plus 1 different. But these two can be common. If I take 1.4 common, it will be log this positive value in the numerator upon x minus 1. Okay, now out of these two, 1.4 can be taken common. Both are positive, negative, negative, positive, they will be 1.x minus 1 plus 1.x plus 1. This constant k. The answer. The answer of this. Finally, we have obtained the answer of this. This is the answer. Question number 6 we have done. And let's talk about 7th question. So, question number 7 now. Okay, so question number 7. What did you say? Okay, question number 7. Well, 7th is last one. Okay, that is x plus 1 whole square. X plus 2 whole square. This is x plus 1. Sorry. Okay, so x plus 1 is in the numerator. 1 x plus 1 cancel out. Simple question. Let me take. 7th question is x plus 1 upon x plus 1 whole square into x plus 2 whole square into dx. Simply just 1 x plus 1 cancelled out. Finally, we have 1 upon x plus 1 only one independent variable. This is x plus 2, sorry. X plus 2 whole square into dx. This is a repeated one. So finally, the same thing again. 7th question. X plus 1 of an x plus 1 whole square into x plus 2 whole square. Okay, dx. So let 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 whole square is equal to a upon x plus 1 plus b upon x plus 2 plus c upon x plus 2 whole square. Then we 1 is equal to a into x plus 2 whole square plus b into x plus 1 into x plus 2 plus c into x plus 1 only. Okay, so again let me write it as this is x square plus 4x plus 4. This is x plus 2 whole square. Twice a into b, this 4x plus 4. Plus b into this is x square plus 3x plus 2. By 3x plus 2x plus 1x that will 3x. 2 into 1 is 2 plus c into x plus 1 only. Okay, so now value of a and c are calculated. So for value of a, putting or equating x plus 1 or putting as they put x plus 1 equal to 0 or x equal to minus 1, you first, this is first. Okay, let me write here, this is first. Not this, this is first. In the first one, we can substitute all. This is 1 equal to. The first one we substitute x equal to minus 1. Value of a can be calculated only a. So this is minus 1, this is plus 1 square minus 1. Minus 1 square means 1. So negative 4, minus 4 plus 1 will cancel out. Minus 4 is plus 4, cancel out. This is 1 only. A into 1 only. 1. Whether a is equal to 1. A is equal to 1 here. We have calculated. Now c can also be calculated. C is x plus 2 whole square equal to 0 for c. For value of c, put x plus 2 whole square equal to 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0 or x equal to minus 2 4 4. This is x equal to minus 2. Substituting in first, in first equation, we get, in this first equation we get c can be calculated. 1 is equal to, where 1 is equal to a0 equal minus 2 square is 4, positive 4. This is minus 8, this is plus 4, plus 4, 8, and minus 8, 0. B will also be 0, but this is 4, positive 4, this is minus 6, and this is 2 plus 4, 6, so 6 minus 6, 0. Only C is calculated, C into minus 4 plus 1, sorry, minus 2 plus 1, that's equal to minus 2, this is minus 2 plus 1, that was minus 1, I think. This is minus 1 into C, that means C only. So C is equal to minus 1. C is equal to minus 1 here. If I substitute, okay, so A and C are equal, or B, we have to equate the coefficients of x squared, that means equate the coefficients. Okay. So equating coefficient of x squared for value of B, let me write here for value of B, equating coefficients, coefficients of x squared. So we get, what do we get? 0 equal to a, a into x squared is a, plus b into x squared plus b. But a is calculated 1, b is equal to minus 1. 1 plus b equal to 0, implies that b is equal to minus 1, b is equal to minus 1. So finally we have obtained all the values, a, b, c, constant values. And let us therefore express the given fraction in the partial fraction form. So therefore 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 whole square is equal to a is 1, 1 upon x plus 1 minus b is minus 1, minus 1 upon x plus 2, c is plus minus 1, minus 1 upon x plus 2 whole square. Therefore integration of this value, either of this or upon 1 plus x plus 1 into x plus 2 whole square into dx is equal to integration of x plus 1 into dx minus integration of 1 upon x plus 2 into dx minus sign of integration of 1 upon x plus 2 whole square into dx. This is equal to log of x plus 1 minus log of